Thank you, Canon, for supporting our channel.
Hi, I'm Ariel here. So today we'll be shooting on studio on black and white portrait. And this is our model today, Nigel.
Hi.
And I'll be using a Canon RF70-200 for this shot. So for this shot, it will be more focusing on one light and how I use a one light system in this portrait shot. So see you all later. Bye.
Now I'm starting this photography session with the one light setting as always. And yes, as you can see, I'm arranging the lighting from 45 angle degree down to the left, and then I shoot according to his facial details. As you can see, the lighting that hit on him create a very nice rainbow lighting to him. Even though we have a lot of artificial lights here, like the ring light and other light etc, but the speed of the lighting or the shutter speed and ISO, it doesn't make the significant effect on it. And as you can see now further front, I try to adjust the model according to his height and then his facial expression, then and adjust the power etc, because I don't want to create the very strong contrast and shadow feel on his this portrait session. And you can see that I adjusting to his side, his poses with very simple instruction. Just move up and down, turn the body and tilt down. As you can see, I never need to touch the model at all, and giving a very brief instruction. And as you can see, just a very brief instruction, we have this kind of nice photos. A poses that simplify enough can make your model pop in front of the camera. You see? Nothing, I didn't touch him at all, and just give a very brief instruction, and you can see the result come up very nicely and very simple. On this photography session, so you can see the lighting, I doesn't have a lot of changes, and then I try to create some very nice remembrance on his face and the backdrop. The backdrop doesn't have a very white color backdrop because I want to have a very contrast and very nice black and white photos, and you can see that I just controlling a very bit of his movement only. So for these photos, you can see that I try to take advantage of the 70-200 by using a more longer distance lens, and I try to move model as less as I can. And then you can see the lighting doesn't move at all, but I want to create a very nice rainbow lighting to this shot. Even though the white background is have a strong shadow feel, but this is a result that I want to create for this black and white shootings. And as you can see here, that all of these photos is very natural and very pop out of his figures, because he's a very good side figure on the left hand. So I try to adjust. And when we studio lightings, if you have adjust the sitting or the standing or the model poses, try to adjust the lighting accordingly to ensure that a lot of light hit on the model face itself, not on the ground or to the backdrop itself. So you can see that I try to minimize the lighting spill to other places, and you can see that the lighting is almost hit a lot of thing to the model itself, but it still retain a very nice rainbow lighting to the model faces. An important thing to note when you are posing models doing the sitting or standing pose, try to arrange the lightings towards the back side of his face, and the face always face on the light itself. Don't ask the model to move quite frequently backward thing or far away from the lighting, because it will cause the face to be not significantly lightened enough, and it doesn't create the mood or the feeling that I need for this film. Ensure that I personally thought of myself on black and white photography is try to make your black and white as simple as possible and without less more posing, so that it will come out very nice, and try to be simplified on all the backdrop etc, so you have a very nice black and white. Next time I will try to do another session with the black and white on a black backdrop, because I used to do an exhibition on black backdrop, and it came out very very interesting and very nice and very mysterious. This is just a basic touch up of the white backdrop. I hope to see you all next time.
I finish our shot today. Thank you, Nigel, for participating, and I will link his Instagram ID in description below. So if you have any question want to ask regarding the lens or the lighting I use, comment below and I will answer you as soon as possible. So see you all next time, and please subscribe to my channel. Bye.